This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. Welcome back to Spindling and the tutorial Lashed. For this tutorial, you'll need a pair of scissors and some top. Top works best for this because all of the fibers are going in the same direction, and that just works best. So we are going to be cutting our top into 2-inch sections. Says you and every other like spindler out there.
I have no idea how this is gonna go. Feels like a mess.
Do you feel guilty?
Yeah.
So I'm just stacking my little cut pieces. How long are your pieces?
Well, aside from that one. That one.
Okay, I think that will work. If you're having a hard time getting the texture, cut those in half. But they might work.
Okay.
The key is you want it's short enough to create texture on the outside, but you don't want it so short that it falls apart because it's too short of a staple length. Try that, yeah.
Okay.
Start with that. Okay, so grab a spindle. I feel like I've used the big one for almost the whole series, and you're using the medium mm-hmm. for the whole series.
Mm-hmm.
But I know for plying, we're going to use the bulky one. I personally rarely spin lace weight, so I don't know if I'll touch the lace weight one. Okay, so I'm going to put all my little bits here. Now what you do... Okay, so you have this end is cut and this end is cut. This top smooth edge is the fold. We are going to be spinning from the fold. So we're going to spin, we're going to attach our fiber, correct. So cut end, we're going to spin from the fold. So you put your leader on the fold. See? We're spinning from the middle. Oops, and we're going in a clockwise direction. And it creates a fuzzy eyelash texture.
Whoa, it does! I think you're right, though. I think it was too long.
Yeah. I'm just doing this close up so people mm-hmm. can see, because otherwise it looks exactly the same as spinning, but mm-hmm. it's all about cutting and then spinning from the fold. And that's it.
That's amazing.
That's all. It's really fun. When I was doing my wheel spinning, whoa. series, this was one of the most popular techniques because it's so easy and so fun.
Like, if you're angry, you can make a lashed yarn.
Yes.
It's good therapy.
So fast.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna cut them in half and see what happens.
Yeah, I think you'd be happier.
Look how cool. That's amazing.
The only thing that's different about, well, the major thing about this yarn is you cannot set this yarn. Everyone I've known who has tried to set it has told me that it ruins the texture. It looks kind of matted and like a giant cat hairball. So don't set it and don't use it for anything that will need to be washed. It's kind of like a fuzzy blanket or like an old teddy bear that once you start really wearing on it, it starts looking bad. Like it's not durable. So for wall hangings and other, they're after us.
Oh, look at the difference. Yeah.
Yes, huge difference. Any weights? Yeah, I recommend this yarn for something that isn't going to get a lot of wear and tear.
This would be nice to weave too.
Yes. With this blended, it's like a custom blend top. I'm really blown away. Hello, hello, Spindle, get it together. With how the colors are going together. I would definitely recommend checking out BZB Fibers on Etsy and seeing if she has any blended tops available. Hobbledy Hoy is another artist who does hand-pulled rovings, and that would be a really good fiber for this as well. But yeah, it's really incredible.
It makes it look expensive.
Yes. Makes it look like a Muppet. A really expensive Muppet.
Yes, okay. That too.
Mine looks like a Muppet. Yours looks like boutique. But yeah, you can see why this was a lot of people's favorite.
It just looks like it should be harder to do.
And I think the thrill of cutting the top in the beginning makes people go like, what are you doing?
Ooh. It's like a magic trick.
Mm-hmm. You can also do a similar technique to this with locks. If you take the locks and put them, just kind of stack them like how we have our top stacked, where the ends and the tips are all in the same direction, and you spin from the fold from the middle of them. I'll show you an example of that before we go. But you can have a similar texture to this, spinning locks. Like that.
Wow.
Is this your new favorite?
This might be my new favorite. I did not expect it.
I didn't expect this to be your new favorite either. I thought you'd kind of be bored by this, like,
No, but it's fast. Fascinating.
It's fast.
It is.
It's like instant gratification.
Yes.
You could use this lashed technique in a blocked yarn and do like a couple yards of lash and a couple yards of locks, or you can also do this lashed technique and create lashed knots or lashed braids in your yarns. And of course, you can ply lashed yarns using any of the plying techniques in this masterclass series. So really this whole series is just to be built on top of each other.
The little fibers are making my nose itch.
Yes. Never do this with Angora.
Oh.
It's instant allergy attack for me.
Isn't it? It's so soft.
It's like teddy bear yarn.
Yeah.
I'm done.
Kind of in focus.
Yeah, super cute.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can get this in focus more. There we go. Yeah, you can see.
That's cool.
Very, very pretty. There you go.
All right.
And that's lashed. Yay. Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy spindling.